Hi guys, Spectre here. Welcome back to some more Total Warhammer 3. Continuing my Greasers campaign. I apologise if I cough at all throughout the recording. Again, I'm still not well. And I do my recordings in batches, so I've got content for at least the next 3 or 4 days. Raise the volcano. We can move now. Oh, we're waiting, aren't we, for a heal because of that thing. Oh, that's Drazhoath himself. Right. And hope you guys are having a good day. If you are, please subscribe as well. We're still making that push towards, well, our next mile marker is actually 500. But after that, obviously, pushing towards the next one. But our overall aim is to get above 1,000. What I mean, for above 1,000 within the first 6 or 7 months of this year. So, end of July, end of June, something like that. One of those two. That's what I thought he'd do.
Eternal fire. Let's have a look on the boats.
Bring me ale. I could barely move anywhere with that. Fuck that. Because he can either defend the city or he can defend the town. He can't defend both. So I'm going to leave him. This is like where your chess maneuvers come in. I'm now leaving the choice on him. Does he want to defend his city or does he want to defend his town? Obviously, for me personally, I defend the city. Fuck the town. Cities are way more important than a town. A city, I would say, is worth 2 or 3 towns. Easily. Because that's where you're going to get your best units from. Your biggest amounts of money. Three turns and that camp's fully upgraded. I've then just got to recruit the rest of the units for it, because they'll get one more rank on. I'm keeping that there at Mutton as a temporary camp. Same with that one. I might build a permanent camp. I'm just not sure where I would build one personally. I mean, that might not be a bad spot actually. Or I could build one here. Somewhere around here. Is that what the other one looks like? I'm just curious about this. I'm assuming then. No, that one's different. So maybe it's based upon where you place them or something then? Because see, that looks really tiny. So that obviously, the what I'm looking at is here is the visual effect. So that must change as you upgrade the encampment. It must have a bigger, more impressive look, but there are two different ones because the one on the island looks different to the one in the mountains. It actually looks like you would do a town as well, really. Town might look slightly bigger. Yeah, some of the towns look bigger. But then again, that town looks bigger than the fucking city. So, how many settlements has he got left? Let's have a little look. He's got six. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right, okay. So, Fortress of Vorag and Nagashizar are his last two cities. The rest of them are all towns. So, if I take away his cities, I take away his ability to recruit good units. Because then he can recruit up to tier 3. So it shuts down his offensive capabilities quite drastically. Oh, no. You declared war on me, dickhead. I'm gonna have my pound of flesh. Well, considering he's a fat chaos dwarf, probably more than a few pounds of flesh. Hey, they wiped him out. Get a fuck Kugath. About what? Didn't he have a bigger army? You don't cover that far. Although it is saying we don't. Do we take it? We do. Okay. Weird. The boss. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wait there, and we'll launch a combined assault next turn, both my armies, on Fortress of Vorag. Black Fortress Camp. Okay. Bloody hell. Of course they have. But he moved there with his army to attack that encampment that's worth literally nothing to me. Okay. Does make me wonder, because if they get this at tier 3, which is maximum ogres can have it have, if they have this at tier 3, if they take it back, do they get it as a tier 3 city? As somebody doesn't go down above them? God, that's good. We'll game that one, because then I can get that one as well, and then they've got an extra 4 leadership there. I mean, that's not bad for giving it to him, but I don't expect as much from the Tyrants. To me, they're more like your character killers, your single entity killers. I'd rather keep that one. Thank you. the other one. We want both of those actually, don't we? Yeah. They're both good. Fucking a lot of Minotaurs and Cygos. Fucking. Including the Lord, that's 9 single entities. That's over half the fucking army. Give it a fight. So the reason it's giving the auto resolve so high on this is because, well, one, you've got a legendary lord, you've got two heroes, and then you've also got a regiment of renown. So, but they've got hobgoblins and two orc slaves, which are complete crap. A normal orc unit will chew through them, and noblars might even outfight orc labourers. So the only other thing they've got is Chaos Dwarf Blunderbusses. And they're not amazing in combat because the Hobgoblin Wolf Riders are also dog shit. So half their army is terrible. It's just whether I can beat the other half. And then obviously you've got things like that, which is a bit of a problem. Because Drunken Mortars just don't want to die sometimes. If he splits up his army, though, he's a bit of an idiot, because his army's too small to really split up, so if he splits up his army, that's advantage me. And because he hasn't really got any melee Chaos Dwarves, he's just got range ones, I'm not as worried. Because my ogres, even though these are armoured, and they'll do less damage against them, they'll still beat him in combat. He has split up his army. A tiny little bit, what the fuck? Orc Labourers and Chaos Dwarf Blunderbusses over there. Such a strange thing. Right. Oh, they've got holes in the walls already. Both the holes are over here. But they're deployed over... Alright. That's bizarre. As far as I'm aware, he only had, I think, 7 units. So there's 2. There's 5 there, they're all there, aren't they? Right. Go, that's fine. Righty. Oh no, we had 9, he might have 2 heroes over there, shit. That is unbreakable as well, so it has to die. Yeah, they have fucking at least one of the heroes over here. Actually, no cup. It's an idea. Avatar back there. Destroy that, I don't think. Well, eat fuck all way, that's good. Angerbot. What the fuck am I saying here? So, this genius is attacking the gates when they've got 2 open wall sections. This guy's climbing the wall? Must have been climbing one inside this padded room. Absolute whack job. If we kill that, we could definitely win this. Because he's not very good in combat, and neither is two heroes. He's aiming at the ones on the wall, which is even better. I just put them there as a fucking distraction, personally. What kind of is
thank you. Oh, is he still there?
Also got him hammering into the corner. To rest for a bit. So you're telling me the majority of balance of power is in all his characters? Hate it when an army gets couched by characters alone. Start to regain his shield as well, fuck me. god. What's the point in rallying to break a second later? Right, that's him dealt with. Okay. Got some sort of ability that's quite nasty on groups. I can understand if it was like a Black Oak Big Boss or a Exalted Champion. Or like a Minotaur Doombull or something. But not an Inferno Castellan. They're a ranged character for a start, but not good in combat. No, no, what? How? All my units just suddenly lose their morale to one fucking hero. Are you kidding me? All they've got left for that 99% dead hero, and then the Lord, who I was going to snipe with the towers. I've got to go back and take that fucking city off him again. At this point, he's just being a pest. Did it even take it? Good God. I don't know what happened there. Because they weren't capturing points. All of a sudden, all my leadership just went down to zero. How? We were winning that fight. Call some bullshit on that one. That one. This'll do the trick. This place is rotten all over. Oh, I forgot about them. Only other thing he can take what he's got there is like a small temporary encampment like that. If he even fights that, he loses. These two units are garbage. He's almost dead, leaving just him. And Zartan's not that good. Oh, it's not Zartan. It's Drazhoath, isn't it? He might be better because I think he's more of a spellcaster as well. Survivor of the flame trial. Right, we're going to call this part here. We'll resume it next time. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have, leave a like. If you're new, please subscribe, help grow the channel. In the top of the description will be the playlist to the entire series. There will be two other videos you'll see on the screen if it's content you've not seen before. Some extra videos there for you to watch. And I hope you guys all have a great day. Take care, everyone, and I'll catch you all soon.